know what you're trying to do. That kind of thing, what kind of thing.
Thank you. Praise we be to the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to new life and lives still in all those who follow the way of peace, justice, and love. Today we come to remember before God our sister in Christ, Joanne Elaine Getch Johnson, to celebrate who she was, the impact she had on the world around her, and to declare with assurance that just as surely as God loved her in this life, that same love now enfolds her with an infinite quality that surpasses our understanding. She now rests in the eternity of God's everlasting love. In the stillness of this place, we now turn to God, who is our beginning and our end. From dust we have been made, and to dust we return. Let us pray. Loving God, come to us in this the hour of our loss. We ask for the presence of your Spirit, that it may comfort us and bring us peace. Be with us now. Give us reassurance of your hope as we meditate on the life of Joanne, one of your beloved children. Creative One, we gather here today not only to remember but to celebrate. For now we know that as Joanne's love lives on in the lives of those gathered here, so too she lives now eternally in your embrace. Comfort us, loving God. Keep us mindful that our own years are but a watch in the night, that in your time we too will be gathered unto you. Be with all those here. Extend your hand to catch their tears. Fill them with the love of your Spirit, and keep us mindful of the truth that whenever we are bold enough and brave enough to truly love one another, that same love lives on eternally in you. Amen.
With sunlight shining.
from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, beginning in verse 1. Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
She married Conrad Connie Johnson on July 27,
1951 in Sioux City. Together, they had three children, Kathy Johnson Gastro, Marty Johnson, and Roger Johnson. Joanne attended Central High School and worked at Palmer Candy Store for many years. She enjoyed golfing, fishing, bowling, playing cards, arts, and crafts, Shrine Auxiliary, and teaching her grandchildren how to swim. She loved her family and getting together as often as possible and watching her grandchildren and great-grandchildren grow. She loved traveling to Arizona and Texas during the winter months and made many wonderful friends that they stayed close with for many years. Survivors include her brother, Roger Getch, and his wife, Nancy, her daughter, Kathy Johnson Gastro, her son, Marty Johnson, her son, Roger Johnson, and his wife, Cindy Wheelock Johnson, eight grandchildren, Autumn Johnson, Zwake, Dan Gastro, and Hillary Rice, Sam Gastro, Miles Johnson, and wife, Stacia Johnson, Sage Johnson, and fiance, Paul Homestead, Bailey Johnson, and husband, Josh Johnson, Ross Johnson, Marisa Williams, Jamie Johnson, Monine, and husband, Kirby Monine, and 10 great-grandchildren, Melanie, Madeline, Riley, Avery, Harper, Finn, Maddie, Peyton, Cora, and Ruby. She was preceded in death by her parents, husband, brothers, and their wives, Roland and Mary Brown Getch, and Marvin and Blanche Spender Getch, Jerry and Mary Baker Getch, Sister Beverly Getch, and Claire Juke, son-in-law, Dan Castro, and many nieces and nephews who are all very cherished and loved, along with her special friends Tom and Colleen Schroeder, Dan and Gary Harbeck, and Ron Brewer. Thank you. today, I am delivering on Kathy's behalf. This is by far the most emotional letter I have ever written, and I want it to be special for Mom. There is a bond that holds her in my heart, and the experiences we have had, the laughter, the tears, and as most mothers and daughters, the tips. But I will cherish and be thankful for all the time that I had with her. And I pray we will be together again. My mother had a heart of gold, the spirit of a child, a goofy sense of humor, and always made things fun. Many years ago, I wrote a poem for Mom's birthday. She asked if I would make a needlework for her to frame, and I did. She cherished, as I did, her. Here it is, for you, Mom. April 21st, 1953, a very lovely lady gave birth to me. Your birthday, also, the chances are so rare for a mother and daughter today to share you, Mom, and my special friend whose love is always there. For many years you made the day just mine because you care. Your help is always there. I'm proud you are my mother, among my richest blessings. Thank God I have no other. As our years go by together, they seem to speed away. And Mom, that's why you're cherished more each and every day. The songs selected have very special meaning to Mom. Especially, "You Are My Sunshine," she told me. That her and Dad would play that song on the piano at her parents' home on one of their first dates. I can just picture them sitting there in the parlor together, Mom playing and then singing the song together, not knowing their future or the wonderful family they would create. To honor my mother in a few paragraphs is truly impossible. Her love for life was unmeasurable. Her love for her family was deeply compassionate and loyal. Her imagination for designing and creating art and crafts was from her heart. She so loved all the following: playing cards, fishing, bowling, golfing with Sam, Roger, Paul, and Kathy North, playing cards, kayaking, planning family get-togethers, making cotton candy, playing cards, going to Colorado to see Sam, Sam coming from Colorado to see her, face painting, making popcorn balls every Halloween, playing cards. Her friends Todd and Gary called Hart Harnack. Her friends Tom and Colleen Schroeder, playing cards. Coffee and Ivy with the gang. Having her hair done with Donna. Traveling to Arizona and Texas every winter. All the activity with the Shriners and the Women's Auxiliary. Playing Shanghai with Sage and Mel and Ty and Tad. She so loved Christmas and always made it special. Going over to visit Roger and Nancy as often as we could. Teaching many of her grandkids how to swim, going over to Grandma's pool. Going over to Grandma's pool was always so fun. And of course, she loved playing cards. much. They were her other daughters. Judy and Dawn were fortunate to be able to come to see Mom almost every month, and she loved it. In the most recent years, Tom, Doris, Diane, Lori, Mom, and I were fortunate enough to do a fantastic road trip, courtesy of Lori, to New Jersey to visit Mom's brother, Marvin, Barb, Morgan, and Rhonda. The trip has so many cherished memories. The past few years have been so very sad from all the dear friends we have lost. Don Harbeck, Dave Harbeck, Uncle Marvin, Colleen Schroeder, Betty Wheelock, Aunt Mary, Jolene, just within the last 3 years. Mom and I have the blessing of being close to them all daily, along with all of their families, who I cherish and will for the rest of my days. Mom and I had our special angels on earth. I would like to give a special thanks to who were there for us every day for many years with Mom's dementia. Dan, my son, Roger, my brother, Diane, my sister, our wonderful neighbors, and Julie, my broker. God bless you all. I know for the past few years, some of my mom's family and friends would have absolutely loved to have been closer to her. But due to being miles away and her difficult condition, it was very hard, both emotionally and physically, and we totally understand and cherish you all. This last week, we want to thank all of her friends and family who reached out via phone, text, in person, cards, gifts, and food. Each one of you have touched our hearts. We are so very thankful for each and every one of you. Now I have to say, party on, our beautiful mom, grandma, aunt, friend, and give all those who have all passed on before us a big hug. Love you. Now, at this time, we would like to invite any family members or friends that would like to share memories of Joanne to come forward if you so choose at this time. I know that this is a difficult time for everyone, and don't think that just because you didn't come forward that we all know all of her. And so those who feel comfortable and able to, you're welcome to come forward to share your memories of Joanne.
What a crowd we have here. Thank you guys for all coming. Beautiful lady here, she was our sunshine of the family. Kathy mentioned the trip to see Bobby and Uncle Marvin. What a wonderful time. We took her out on a boat, we were gonna go deep sea fishing, but the water was too rough, so the captain took us into a bay. She was ready to go. And we told her she had to just drop her line because it was bottom fish we were fishing for, flounder. And every once in a while she would look at that captain and she'd go. She did not like dropping her line. She wanted to cast it. Very soft. That was a really good day we had there. And I was so happy to be able to go to Blanche Lake one more time with her a couple years ago. Had her out fishing with Danny in the boat. We had her playing ladder ball, which she beat us at. And she had a fun time. I love y'all. Loved her. And I will miss her.
She loved her golf league at Sun Valley, where she had many friends. They played golf with cards and lunch following every week during the season. The winter months led her to bowling at the Buzz Bowl. There, she was a leader, as well as being on multiple leagues, winning many tournaments. Even while she was involved in all these activities, she loved to go fishing with Connie. They went on many wonderful fishing adventures and had lots of fun. Together, they were lucky enough to go on many awesome vacations. But I think what they loved most was the family Minnesota vacation to Blanche Lake. Filling the resort with family and friends, they played cards, fished, played horseshoe, took the kids water skiing, drank coffee, prepared meals, and some adult beverages, and wonderful conversation with lots of laughter. They did this on an annual basis for many years. In 1977, they installed an in-ground pool where she loved to entertain, swim, and sunbathe. She loved her pool. She was a very beautiful, strong, active, social woman. Her memory will certainly live on. God speak to you, Joanne.
Yeah, growing up as a grandson of Joanne, it's like hitting the lottery. Yeah. It was the best. She had a swimming pool. She always had candy. Her house was fun. She always made it fun. She was always so loving.
So I'm relatively new to the family, but I always just remember how welcome Grandma always made me feel, you know, just walking in the door and that big hug, and, you know, it's really made me feel at home, and, you know, it's kind of weird going in there last night and just expecting her to be there, and she wasn't, and, but yeah, just, you know, something you always kind of remember, and I'm not sure if it's been mentioned yet, but she loved playing cards, and I was, loved the Shanghai, and, I just had so many close calls, I could never get the win, and I'll always remember how just ruthless she was, like, just just giving me crap about not winning. And finally, you know, a couple weeks ago, I finally got the first win. I think I actually shared it with Grandma, but first ever victory right before that. And I always remember 3 weeks ago, I went and played around golf, and it was a beautiful day, and to being able to be out there with her and Sage, and we didn't really challenge her scorekeeping. That was nice, but she always asked me what club I was using, so I had to, like, run the math in my head about four clubs up for what to tell her to use. But towards the end of the round, she the soles of her shoes blew out, so instead of just, you know, we could just turn around and went home, but she wanted to keep going, so we she played the last, like, three holes barefoot. And she may have even actually been playing better. I think she even got a par, like an actual real par, not with what she said so far. But then, you know, I just feel like that's such a really summed up Grandma, just how, you know, maybe things didn't go perfectly, but she just had that great upbeat attitude and was able to go through it and just really you know, make the most out of it, whatever the situation was. And that's something that will always stick with me. And as people said too, just Kathy, you know, how well you were with her, and just giving, you know, being able to give her the best quality of life she could have right up to the end. And we'll always remember Grandma.
What a light. As an example, she was not a pleasant. She liked the cards. You know? She wanted to like to win, but she liked. She did not like to lose. I have so many memories of Joanne. I have known Joanne, I think, since I was in junior high. The family. Maybe even, I think, before that. Late grade school. Right, Mark? Maybe all the way through grade school. Definitely. Yeah, wait a minute. And what a ride it's been, you know? And what a blessing that their family was to mine. And Kathy's dad and my dad were best friends. Best friends. Yeah. And my mom and your mom, these last few years, how sweet. And thank you for what you did for your mom and for your mom. You are a blessing, and I love this family. Thank you. You will always be a part of mine.
Happy birthday, Grandma. Dear Grandma, I'm so grateful to have you as my grandmother. You taught me many skills that I still use to this day. Not only have you taught them to me, but also with your teaching, have came many opportunities to show others my talents, thus allowing me to feel good about myself. I've always loved our talks about Grandpa. Though you and I, through you, I have been able to love him because the man is helping me get closer to him. I remember when I was younger and we would go out for coffee with your dad. And I also remember always getting smothered hash browns, and I must say, I have not found anywhere that makes them as good as I remember them being there. I also remember waking up at Grandma's to breakfast. You were always up before us. I did not know this at the time, but you had to make a special trip to the bank together. Oh. I also remember the crisp dollars you used to give us for Christmas. Those were nice. I didn't know it at the time, but you made a special trip to the bank to get those for us when we were kids. I also remember the bags you got us when we were kids. I had a green one, and they tied in the front. I also remember on vacation when all the adults would play cards in the adult cabin. And you would let us play Indian poker in your cabin, something we may not have told you, but after you put the bag candy away after giving us each a reasonable amount, we would watch where you put it and wait for you to leave, and then play with the whole bag. I'm sure that you didn't eat any of it. I am sure you knew, but never outed us for it. So thank you. Happy birthday to our dearest grandma. To know you, we must be lucky. We send you love with every smile. With people afar, it just takes a while. You are all things beautiful and sweet. And the being everybody prays to me. A spirit truly unique in nature. An inner truth, love, and nurture. Another year now has passed. Your knowledge now is so very vast. Your wisdom deep within, your everlasting grandma. I love you indefinitely, that there is a fact, and I will carry you always in my heart. On me, you have made this an impact. So, somebody wrote that. I wrote down some things to say about grandma. There's just so many, and she has such a spirit that I see in everybody, all the cousins and all the family. When Roger laughs, when Sam laughs, Miles Ross, when you guys laugh, it just reminds me of Grandma. And you guys again. What it is. She loved us so much. We were so lucky. And I just think of Aunt Mary and Aunt Bev just growing up. All the fun, happy times going to rummage sales, Marty. We'd always go to the ones with toys. Jeez, we'd get broken toys every time. Looking for the pieces. And of course, our know-it-all grandma saying, oh, we told you, should have got the clothes. Put some nice in these pants. We're going to wear all these clothes on after this. But it was the price we paid. Go rummaging. Crazy ladies, and they didn't care. No, I'll miss her so much, but, you know, thanks everybody for speaking. The last few years have been rough. And she's in a great place now. And I can feel her spirit. And that's all we need. Our next music selection is the old rugged cross. You can find that in the New Century Pinball pew rack there on page 195. And you are welcome to sing along.
Now may the love which is stronger than death and which binds us together in the unity of life energize our spirits with divine stillness of God's loving presence. And may that stillness of God be in our minds, the warmth of God be in our hearts, and the wholeness of God surround each of us all the days of our lives. Go now in God's peace.
We have a luncheon in the basement, and we do have a chairlift that will get you down to the basement if you don't want to do the steps. So please head down there if you're not going to go to the cemetery.